Hello, my name is Nelly, and welcome back to another video. Today we're talking about the Gemini wallet. So if you have this, I will show you how to do your crypto taxes with the help of Coinly. The breakdown of this video is pretty straightforward. We're going to talk about the wallet itself for a little bit, then I'm going to jump into the integration, which itself is also really easy, and then I'm going to show you how to get the necessary tax documentation depending on obviously where you live. And then lastly, I'll have an outro where you can go, and if you have any questions, if you want to talk to members of our community, I will leave links for that. But without further ado, let's jump into today's video. Okay, so this exchange is based out of New York, USA, and was founded in 2014. It is currently a top 20 exchange by trading volume. It has some pretty standout features like a payments app, customer funds insurance, and even its own stablecoin called the Gemini Dollar. They are currently in the process of making their own credit card, which is said to offer up to 3% back on purchases and will allow users to earn rewards in Bitcoin and in other cryptos on Gemini. And since this is a US wallet, I will also direct you guys to an article, which I will leave down below. We have a very comprehensive guide that's been updated already multiple times that has all the information you need to know if you're doing crypto taxes in America. So strongly recommend that. Some really awesome information. A lot of people work to create a really detailed article. Okay, so jumping into the integration part of this video, we're gonna jump into Coinly, log into our account, go to the wallet section, find this exchange. It's not gonna be too hard. And we have two different options. I'm gonna show you both. We have the setup autosync, which is using the API. And then we have we're allowing you to import a CSV file, which I will also show you that one. But let's start off with the setup autosync. So we need a API key and a API secret, which we can find on their exchange. So here is my Gemini wallet in the top right corner. We're looking for account, and we're gonna go on settings. And then on the left side in the settings here, we have the API. We're gonna click that, and we're gonna click create API key, which you will need a 7-digit authentication code. So once you've created that, you'll get this screen that says you'll be creating an API key and secret. First, select the scope you want to create an API key for. So we have two different options. One of them is a master API key that says we can create new accounts, transfer funds, view balances, trade. We're not interested in that. We're only interested in the primary one for more general purposes, like just being able to view transactions so we can calculate your crypto taxes. So anyways, pick primary and click next. And here is your API key. So we're gonna go back and paste it here. And then we have our API secret. We're gonna paste that there. And here is very important what you're interested in selecting: API key settings, fund manager. We're not interested in trading. We're not interested in auditor. We are interested in. So allows this read only API to check balances, check the status of orders, see transfers such as deposits, withdrawals, see all active orders, see trade volume, and see past trades. So we're not interested in moving, touching any funds. We're only interested in the read-only API. And then just click here. I have copied and pasted my API secret to a safe place and understand I will not be able to access it again, and click create. So there you have it. And here we're gonna click secure import, and we're gonna wait a few minutes while these transactions load into Coinly. And our transactions have been loaded in. We have three different transactions and some currencies that I've been working with. Okay, the second part of this video, if you're not interested in the API route, no problem. We have another option for you, which is the CSV file. So we're gonna go back and create another wallet. We're gonna click import from file this time. Okay, so this time we're back on this dashboard area in the top right corner. We're looking for account and we're looking for balances. And here in the right side, we have a little arrow pointing down with almost like a box. We're gonna click that, and we have a couple different files, but we're only really interested in one. So we have a tax documents, we have a history, we have the trading volume, and we have the account statement. So we're looking, we're only interested in the history, and here you can select a date that is best suited for your needs. You can select, I believe, an entire year, so you don't have to worry about only being able to select in 3-month increments, which some exchanges do have. So I'll select from the beginning of the year, or actually from the beginning of when I've, when this platform came out, looks like 2015, all the way to November 2nd, which is today's date. And now that file that I've generated has my entire transaction history. Even though I've only used it for a few days, I downloaded potentially my entire lifetime of transactions on this exchange. But we're gonna take that file, drag and drop it into Coinly, and we're gonna click import, and then we're also gonna wait a few seconds and it's already done. And the same three transactions that we had before through the API have also now been imported in the same, in a different manner using the CSV file. So that was pretty straightforward. Let's show you how to get the necessary tax documentation. So let's go to tax reports. Here is where you will get a summary of your capital gains, your trades, deposits, withdrawals, costs and expenses. Everything is there. Here we have a little section where you can select the appropriate tax plan. So we have quite a few options, which I will tell you right now. So for the US, which might be of interest to most of you, we have the IRS Schedule D Form 8949. You can also export to TurboTax, both online and desktop versions. For the UK, we have the capital gains, the HMRC capital gain summary. We have reports for Norway, Sweden, Switzerland. For Australia, we have the ATO tax report. And then for other countries like Germany, Canada, and so on, we have the complete tax report. And this complete tax report is a document you can also give to an accountant to combine with your other tax documents, or alternatively, you can invite them to the Coinly platform to set up their accountancy firm. We're still working on more content for that. And lastly, do not forget to check your country's rules in terms of tax reports and if they're deductible, because some countries you might be able to include the cost of this service, which is helping you with your taxes. But that brings us to the conclusion of this video. There are plenty of different resources you can use. They will be linked down below. First off, we have the Coinly Help Center, where we have countless articles on crypto and crypto tax related topics. Then we have a forum section where you can talk to members of our community as well as our staff. And then lastly, we have a contact section where you can send us an email or a message, and we'd be happy to get back to you. But if you found this video helpful in any way, consider dropping a like, subscribing for more crypto content, and I'll see you next time. Peace.